What lessons do you learn from this whole COVID-19 thing? So is there something that you change when it comes to SEO? Are there things that changed, or is this a bigger topic now, SEO for your clients or within your industry?
No, I think we've been, look, it's interesting. I don't think there's been any massive changes to our industry. I think the people that have invested more in their marketing are actually going to be the ones that come out on top. So historically, and now it's been no different, is marketing is the first budget to be cut when in tough times. But all the research shows that when you double down on your marketing in tough times, it's what pulls you out on top at the when things get better. So I think the most obviously, I have a self-interest in people spending money on marketing. But
you do.
It also, yeah, I do. But it allows you to rebuild everything and not from a, you know, scrap everything. But it's what's really important? What's going to get the cut through? What's going to make the most difference? And it's no different to the 80-20 rule that goes throughout your business, is there'll be 20% of your marketing that's actually giving you 80% of the results, right? So how do we find what that 20% is? Let's double down on that 20%. So it's now 40%, and that gives us 160%, if my maths work out correctly. That's the result. So now's the time you got to invest in the process and build the right assets and collateral and things you've been thinking of that you just haven't had time to, or they've been on the back burner. This is the beautiful time to be doing that. And it's, once again, we're getting a bit too late. I think the other really interesting thing is, and we talked about this just briefly beforehand, was people trying to make the shift into digital now versus when they weren't prior to COVID. And I think the experiences that we're seeing in Australia is they've found it a really rude shock. So they're trying to play catch up to people that have had 5+ years learnings and experience and growth. And they're trying to compete in that space without understanding the amount of time, energy, and effort and resources it takes to get digital up and working for you. So the smart ones will work it out, and they'll be prepared to invest in it. And the ones that, once again, niche in the right areas. But I think for 80%, 90% of people, is that they're going to be flogging a dead horse because they haven't gone through the trials and tribulations of what it takes to make things work in the digital world.
Yes. So to some degree, you can buy into the learning curve, but after a while, it's not possible.
Correct. Correct. So 20 and 20 years ago, you could open a retail shop in a retail strip and you'd make good money maybe 30, 40 years ago. And that just doesn't work anymore. You've actually, once again, the smartness of people and their ability to choose is astronomical. So this is, once again, why your marketing is so much more important, is you've actually got to prove how good you are. You've got to connect with people. You've got to show them that the value you bring to the party is more than the competitors. You need to fulfill on that promise with the rest of your business. And it's rapidly changing, that, you know, the consumer is the one of choice versus historically you open a store and you'd make money out of it. So it's that shift mentality. If you haven't got that, you're not going to get it in the future. So there's got a lot of people that test and try a lot of things, but they haven't got the learning to go with that to show how important it is to get right.